My time at Leeds Beckett really helped me get to where I am today. I've always wanted to be a graphic designer, I think, from quite a young age. I find things interesting that most people would find boring. I love looking at type and the way things are printed and the colours that are used in just normal basic print.
My name is Chris Welburn and I graduated in 2014 with a Master's degree in sports coaching. There's been a direct correlation between what I learned on the MSc sports coaching and what I do in my current role with the FA. My postgraduate degree gave me some fantastic skills, notably my presentation skills, and the presentation skills that I developed at the university have really helped in my current role, what I do day in, day out.
The thing I'm most proud of is being the first person in my family to go to university and graduate. The academic staff were fantastic, and I decided to do my degree part-time whilst working full-time. And if it hadn't have been for the support of more than one tutor, I often wonder whether or not I would have even made it to the end of year two. They will give you their time. They're very, very interested in developing you as a person and giving you the best start possible in a future career in law.
My name is David Burnett, and I graduated in 2015 with a master's degree in physiotherapy. I always loved people, and I always had a passion for physiotherapy, and being able to come to Leeds Beckett and learn the necessary skills to be a physiotherapist has gotten me to where I am now. Coming from Canada, the NHS has an amazing reputation internationally, and Leeds Beckett connects directly with Leeds Teaching Hospitals and the NHS, so you're able to go on and get the practical skills on placements and as well as leading into the working world.
We explored using photography, moving image, painting, event organising, curation, anything we wanted. A tutor introduced me to one of the competition briefs at the Tetley that secured me a really great relationship with the marketing and PR manager, and through that got me the position of resident designer at the Tetley.
I have a real passion for developing people first and players second. The sports coaching degree was an opportunity to try and understand the who of coaching, so the people I was working with. I wanted to find out a little bit more about what I was coaching and ultimately how I was coaching.
I started from a one lawyer firm, graduated to one of the biggest commercial firms in Leeds, and then came to Cap 6 where I'm very happy, very settled. I deal a lot with property litigation. I deal with serious incidents which take place in hospitals or any healthcare setting. More serious offences, potentially corporate manslaughter, investigations, it's quite varied.
Two years the course took me, fantastic lecturers, great programme and one that's really helped me in my career.
My course really helped me with my career, not in just the way, the practical and technical skills, but also the people and communication skills.
They had elective placements, so I went to Stoke Mandeville Hospital. I had that wonderful opportunity to learn from some of the best physiotherapists in the country.
I have been back to the university to take part in a mini mock assessment centre for LPC students, which was extremely enjoyable.
I also have a really good relationship with the university still. We run briefs with third year students.
While studying on the MSc in sports coaching, I coached the men's and the women's university teams, winning the Bucks Championships in 2013 and 2014.
Having that NHS experience and taking that home, if I was to go home, would be absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, graduates and guests. As Deputy Registrar, it's my great pleasure to open today's formal proceedings. I would like to call upon David Lowen, Chair of our Board of Governors, to address us.
Deputy Vice-Chancellor, graduands, distinguished guests, academic staff, friends of the university, welcome. As Chair of the Governing Board of this university, I carry out a range of duties and attend many gatherings. Some are important, some are difficult, some, like today, are an honour and a privilege. None, though, is as happy as this gathering. Now, I admit I don't get dressed up like this every day of the year, nor do my colleagues. So why do we wear these gowns, robes, hats, bonnets? It's because today is a rite of passage. We dress up because today is special. It's special for our graduands because they have set themselves a difficult goal, and by hard work and determination, they have achieved it. They have earned the right to celebrate and dress up. It's special for our academic staff and the support staff. Today is fulfillment and satisfaction for them also, evidence of a job well done. And today is a special day for friends and families, a day to praise and congratulate those you love and who are receiving honours. If all that is not a good reason to dress up and say today is special, then I'm not sure what is. And because today is special, we hope for, no, we expect plenty of clapping and cheering, loud cheering. So let's start. First, I ask the graduands, please stand. Don't get too excited too soon. Now, graduands, will you please show your appreciation to your enthusiastic families and guests for all their encouragement, love, and support? Right, now stay standing, graduands. Now lecturers, tutors, academic staff, will you please stand and turn and face your former students and please applaud their success. And graduands, please show your thanks to those who have helped so much in your education. Thank you. Teaching staff, academics, please sit. Thank you. Graduates, graduands, stay standing. Now, families and friends, this is your turn. It's time to show how proud you are. Will you please rise, turn, and applaud your exceptional achievers? Okay, will everyone please sit? So I think we agree it's going to be an important and memorable day. To families and friends, to the Deputy Vice Chancellor and all university staff, I say thank you. To those about to graduate, you start the next stage of your life in an uncertain world and in a Britain less certain of its place within it. However, you have the skills and determination to survive and prosper. I wish you good luck and great fortune, and please never lose touch with us here at Leeds Beckett University. Congratulations and thank you.
I now invite Harry Walters, Vice President of the Students' Union, to speak on behalf of all graduating students.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice Chancellor, members of the university community, graduands and guests. As a fellow Leeds Beckett student, it gives me immense pleasure to speak to you on behalf of the Students' Union here today. Today is a day of celebration. Today you get to breathe a sigh of relief. Today years of hard work have finally paid off. And we'd like to give you a huge congratulations for getting this far. It is important today that we celebrate our academic achievements and efforts. We also guarantee there are other memories and experiences that we have all gained as a Leeds Beckett student and that will stay with us forever. Your Leeds Beckett experience is unique to each and every one of you. But it is important to remember that these experiences unify us all as we embark on the next chapter of our lives. We all remember that one moment at uni, that one where you could have easily walked away, that bit of bad news, the endless night in the library, the moment where you could have just given up, but you didn't. You made it through, you got to the end, and you all made it. We got through with the help with some amazing people, many members of university staff, lecturers, your personal tutors, the library staff, and many more, not to forget your family, as well as your sheer determination. A course is not just a course, it's a vibrant community, but you can call your extended family. You met wonderful people along your journey, be it at societies, sports teams, events, in your lecturers, on campus and accommodation. You met amazing people from all over the country and even the world. You've made a rich network of incredible people, trust them, embrace them, value them. You all shared in this experience at Leeds Beckett, so celebrate with these people as they celebrate you today. All of this has given you the skills and prepared you for life after Leeds Beckett. You're ready for the world. You've exceeded at one of life's greatest challenges. Looking ahead, you'll make some mistakes. You make some necessary mistakes. You are now well equipped to get through them and learn from them and continue to grow and be the most amazing person you can be. Thank you.
invite Professor Mohamed Dasbaz, Pro-Vice-Chancellor of the Faculty of Arts, Environment and Technology, to address us.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, guests, and most importantly, graduates. It is my great pleasure to be standing here today, sharing your achievements with you and our guests. Your successes are the driving force and inspiration for all of us, the academic colleagues and the support staff who have helped you through your university journey. The Faculty of Arts, Environment and Technology brings together a wide range of academic and research disciplines. We deliver 36 undergraduate and 30 postgraduate courses recognized and accredited by 22 professional, statutory and regulatory bodies and managed through our 5 academic schools. Our courses place over 7,000 students at the heart of a nationally and internationally renowned education experience. I want to take this opportunity to thank our numerous industry partners who have been very generously working with us and our students over the past years. These include Prime Studios, Provision, Northern Ballet, Yorkshire Dance, Phoenix Dance, Harwood House, and others. Many of our staffs are experienced practitioners in their field, but they also apply and develop research to support their teaching, and more importantly, are committed to providing an excellent learning environment to all our students. During the past year, staff within our 5 academic schools have produced over 180 research outputs, including books, journal articles, conference papers, exhibitions, performances, music compositions, and films. We are very proud also of our students, many of whom are graduating today, and our staff through their exhibition, live dances and music performances, and films, as well as cultural events that has made such a rich contribution to the cultural and artistic fabric of our city and our region. To list all the achievements of our staff and students within the School of Cultural Studies and Humanities and the School of Film, Music and Performing Arts would require much longer than we have time for today, and therefore I will only share some of the highlights with you. Northern Film School's senior lecturer, Philip Robertson, was the director of cinematography on the documentary drama film, Shock, which was nominated for an Oscar this year. Documentary series, India Frontier Railways, which featured the work of several Leeds Beckett graduates and staff, including our colleague Martin Harris, won 2 Royal Television Society Yorkshire Awards. More than 100 staff and students from the Northern Film Schools were involved in a university partly funded project led by Lara Anderson, working with 2 Hollywood producers to produce and create a documentary drama about the last year of Jane Mansfield's life. Our music academic Sam Nichols was featured in a new film about the Leeds music scene. Our students benefited from working with leading industry experts like legendary Beatles engineer Ken Scott, who joined our teaching team this year. Our performing arts graduate Sharon Watson, now the chair of Leeds City Bid for 2023 European Capital of Culture and the director of Phoenix Dance Company, returned to university to share her experience and journey with our students. We strive to support our curriculum with an extensive and successful public guest speaking program organized by our Center for Culture and Arts, which is led by Professor Susan Watkins. The lecture series included How a Performance and Play in the Leeds and Trinidad Carnival by Dr. Zoe Marshall, Retaking the Commons, Culture, Politics and in the Public Realm by Dr. Andrew Lawson and Dr. Cathy Shaw, Doing Urban History in an Urban World by Dr. Shane Ewing, and Women, Visibility and Playful Act by Dr. Liz Sterling, Dr. Casey Orr, Joe Hassel, and Laura Robinson. An important research about LGBT histories led by our Professor Alison Orme had a significant national coverage in the UK media. The innovative and valuable work carried by our staff and students in the School of Cultural Studies and Humanities this year has been further recognized by the UK Art and Humanities Research Council through hundreds of thousands of pounds funding for research projects as well as PhD studentships. Graduates, in conclusion, and in the words of Brian Tracy, make your life a masterpiece. Imagine no limitations on what you can be, or have, or do. I know you will go on to have bright futures no matter which path you choose to follow, and I can't wait to stand here in a year's time boasting about your achievements to our next set of graduates. But before you come on a stage to collect your awards, here are a few comments from some of your fellow graduating students about their time at our university.
I think this course has changed me massively. As an individual, it's made me more confident. It's made me, I think, more experimental. It's definitely given me the confidence to experiment and try out new things and just go for things a lot more.
Some of the greatest things about my course here at Leeds Beckett is the relationship with our tutors. They go the extra mile, and it's not just they're here to teach us a lesson and then we go on our way. They make sure that we've got everything we need and that we're here to succeed.
You really get a wealth of knowledge from every tutor that you have for a seminar or a lecture. And they're all so approachable as well, being able to ask questions, and they're always there at the end of an email or in their office hours.
The course has definitely made me more of an inquisitive person. I like to question everything around me a lot more. It's definitely made me partake in a lot more discussions and debates I normally wouldn't have considered before coming to university.
We've got the new studios up in Headingley, which are fantastic to work in. They're just for us and the dancers, and that's really lovely to have that space.
Coming here to Leeds Beckett and seeing the studios, and that there was more than just two or three, there were five and then a bunch of tiny little studios, but five big full-blown studios with live rooms and everything.
I found that I was always able to do what I wanted, but if I needed help, my tutors were always there to like encourage me and kind of like steer me in the right direction.
After graduation, the first thing I've got planned is to go to the Edinburgh Fringe. I'm working with a Leeds Beckett PhD student, and she's doing a piece based on the work of Richard DiMarco.
I want to go on to do the Masters, so the reason I want to stay here is just because the support network that you develop through 3 years here.
I used to work for Ubisoft Toronto, and my goal was to move into the audio design team, so that's one of my options, is to go back and work for the audio team.
I definitely want to eventually move to London and work in publishing and editing.
Hopefully I want to go on do a PhD, maybe, but for now I just want to focus on the MA.
Thank you.
I now invite Professor Ruth Robbins, Head of School, to present graduands from the School of Cultural Studies and Humanities.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I'm pleased to present graduands for the following awards. For the award of Bachelor of Arts, Media, Communications, Cultures, I present Heather Lingard. Nida Mir. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, English and History, I present Naomi Anderton. Downey Coleman. Lorna Cubbon. Oliver Gochran. Eleanor Green. Maymuna Hanif. Samantha Holmes. Thomas Hughes. Kelsey Kenny. Charlotte Knox. Victoria Moss. Alexander Nangle. Aaron Richardson. Nicole Scott. Alexandra Seddon. Charlotte Simpson. Jennifer Theobald. Catherine Thompson. Charlotte Wright. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours English Literature, I present Maria Abid. Jessica Adlington. Lydia Barrett. Sarah Bonner. Lauren Brown. Rhiannon Chapman. Simran Chatha. Eve Cousins. Yumna Diwan. Caitlin Drury. Amy Gibson. Melissa Groves. Catherine Guest. Liam Guilfoyle. Bethany Hamilton. Paisley Hamilton. Cassandra Hartley. Megan Hawkins. Leanne Hodson. Tia Jowett. Jennifer Kendrick. Claudia Knight. Bethany Llewellyn. Elizabeth Mann. Anna Mapleston. Joseph Mason. Nafisa Masood. Marilyn McBride. Cheyenne Joni Morris. Charlotte Murray. Hayley Myers. Lucy Neve. Misty Nevin. Holly Nicol. Jessica Oakes. Rupa Pithwa. Sophie Ricks. Elizabeth Roberts. Rebecca Smith. Hayley Thistleton. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Outstanding Student Achievement in English Literature, and also the winner of the Sarah Holt Memorial Prize for the Best Dissertation in English Literature, Victoria Turner. Thomas Webb. Christopher Wetham. Lauren Worsley. Edward Younger. For the award of Bachelor of Arts Honours with History, I present Jessica Abbott. Hayley Allen. Leah Atherton. Adil Aziz Malik. Harriet Betts. Aaron Brazen Stewart. Olivia Butterfield. Alistair Butters. George Kane. Matthew Cook. Liam Crossland. Hannah Daly. Rory Duncan. Michael Earnshaw. Louis Ellis. Aaron Glendinning. Adrian Goodhart. Jonathan Grice. Jodie Ann Harry. Charlotte Hetherington. Sophie Hill. William Hine. Emma Hitchman. Kieran Howard. Jack Howarth. Sophie Jefferson. Delano Johnson. Lisa Jones. Abigail Lake. Busena Laudi. Freya Lillywhite. Francesca Maybe. Jamie McCormack. Laura Minto. Samantha Mitchell. Joe Noland. Aidan O'Shea. Kawi Othman. Abigail Patchett. Alexander Rabo. Joseph Rafferty. Megan Rees. Katie Rees-Lowick. Katrina Roden. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Outstanding Student Achievement in History, William Saunders. Shauna Sanderson. Thomas Scorer. Laura Short. Matthew Stocks. Kieran Tierney. Harry Wainwright. Thomas Wakefield. Alex Wilcox. Oliver Wing. Thomas Whittle. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Media and Popular Culture, I present Rhys Term. Rachel Husband. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, Media Communications Cultures, I present Farhad Abuhamra. Fajr Al-Bahar. Hamed Al-Hababi. Gaida Al-Qaeda. Khalid Al-Mari. Re- Rebecca Blakemore. Danielle Breyer. Evangeline Butler Johnson. Stephanie Caldicott. Sophie Cox. Maisie Cromack. Bethany Didner. Elspeth Earhart. Lois England. Laura Evans. Alex Forry. Rennie Francis. Nadia Jabelli. Esther Gibney Hume. Emma Gibson. Ashley Gordon. Marina Haig. Rachel Haran. Rebecca Hart. Courtney Hartley. Aaron Jaffia. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Outstanding Student Achievement in Media, Daniel Kirby. Joshua Lacey. Paige Meyer. Carrera McGrath. Ruby Millington. Daniela O'Sullivan. Katie Rattigan. Gemma Rayner. Marisa Ritson-Stanivuk. Kuljinda Sangera. George Sargent. Francesca Scott. Samuel Shale. Paige Newman. Heather Stiles. George Tipper. Paris Lee Ulla. Ellis Williams. For the award of Master of Arts English Contemporary Literatures, I present Elizabeth Anstice. Lee Colley. Hannah Spruce. Daniel Windass. I now invite Professor Phil Cardew to present research awards for the School of Cultural Studies and Humanities.
Masters by Research is awarded to candidates who have investigated and evaluated the topic using a research methodology appropriate to the subject area. Each candidate will have written a thesis which is examined by a panel of experts. For the thesis titled, A Critical Discussion of the Provision of Public Space for Young People in the UK, Claire's research examines the cultural, socio-economic and policy factors affecting public space and how these in turn affect young people's access to it and provision for them within it. Additionally, it explores ideas for transforming public space, such as theoretical, conceptual, participatory practice and case study analysis. I present Claire Edwards. Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to the candidates who have pursued a programme of individual research leading to a work of publishable quality. Each candidate will have written a substantial thesis and have been examined by a panel of experts at the viva voce examination. For the thesis titled Devising the National Trust, From an Idea to an Institution in a Transatlantic Context, circa 1810 to 1907, Melanie's research reconsiders the origins of the National Trust, from Wordsworth's protestations that landscape could be considered national property and the realization of that idea in America's national parks. It uncovers the transatlantic networks that helped the Trust emerge and reveals the breadth of the Trust's early national and international activities. I present Dr. Melanie Hall. For the thesis titled Country Music as Contested Culture in Post-9/11 America, Identity and Meaning, David's research examines country music as a site of struggle between dominant, alternative and oppositional cultural discourses. It explores how meaning is negotiated in live music scenes and amongst a community of radio listeners and offers new insights into musical experience as a means through which changes of perspective occur. I present Dr. David Robinson. That concludes the presentation of awards for the School of Cultural Studies and Humanities.
I now call upon Tracy Lancaster, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, to give a citation introducing Professor Richard DeMarco, CBE, upon whom our university will confer the award of Doctor of Arts, honoris causa. Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, graduands and guests. It is a privilege and a pleasure to introduce Professor DeMarco, Richard DeMarco, CBE, for the award of Doctor of Arts, honoris causa. Born in Edinburgh in 1930, Richard has been a major figure in the promotion of European arts for more than 60 years, in particular through the Edinburgh International Festival, with which he has been involved every year since its inception in 1947. With a passion for bringing art to the masses in 1963, Richard co-founded the renowned Traverse Theatre in Edinburgh before establishing the Richard DeMarco Gallery 3 years later. For many years, the gallery promoted cross-cultural links. It presented European artists in Scotland and established connections for Scottish artists across Europe. In the early 1990s, Richard transformed the gallery into the DeMarco European Art Foundation, an open educational resource comprising modern and contemporary European art. Richard has promoted cultural links with Europe throughout his career. In fact, his extensive links with Eastern European countries during the Cold War period, built through promoting the work of their artists, were recently praised by the European Union. As a result of his years of work, Richard has amassed a unique archive of material, including artworks, photographs, posters and programs, all of which is now on display at the Summer Hall Performance Venue in Edinburgh. The DeMarco Archive, as it is now known, has become a major asset for students and scholars all across the world, whether they are studying European arts, a particular artistic period, curatorship, developments in cultural policy, or the history of the Edinburgh Festival. Over his years of involvement in the festival, Richard has staged a wide variety of challenging theatre productions, art exhibitions, and other cultural events. Many of the artists, actors, directors, musicians, and filmmakers who first appeared outside their home countries in the Edinburgh Festival venues, including Maria Abramovich, have subsequently become world-renowned. For the 2016 Edinburgh Festival exhibition, the Scottish National Gallery of Art is presenting, in collaboration with the DeMarco European Art Foundation, an exhibition entitled Richard DeMarco and Joseph Boyce, a unique partnership. As an artist, Richard's work is represented in over 2,500 art collections, both public and private, including the Scottish National Gallery of Modern Art, the Victoria and Albert Museum, the British Government Collection, and the National Gallery of Lithuania. Richard has long been a supporter of performing arts here at Leeds Beckett and was instrumental in establishing our performing arts teaching provision. He commissioned our university's first performance at the Edinburgh Festival, and our work with the DeMarco European Art Foundation has resulted in numerous opportunities for students and staff to perform at the festival over the years. Richard's European connections have facilitated international developments in performing arts at Leeds Beckett, and his archive is a crucial research resource for our students and our staff. Richard's contributions to contemporary art have been recognised on numerous occasions. He has received rewards, including the 2013 European Union's Citizens Prize, the Polish Gold Order of Merit, and a CBE in the 2006 New Year's Honours List. Richard continues to paint to this day. In 2010, the Royal Scottish Academy celebrated Richard's 80th birthday with an exhibition entitled A Life in Pictures, alongside a major exhibition, 10 Dialogues, Richard DeMarco, Scotland, and the European Avant-Garde. Richard DeMarco, for your significant contribution to the arts, it is my great pleasure to call on David Owen, Chair of the Board of Governors, to confer on you the award of Doctor of Arts, Honoris Causa.
Well, all I can say is I've waited a long time for this day. Having just celebrated my 86th birthday. I've noted with delight the fact that this campus came into being more or less at the end of the 20s and the beginning of the 30s, more or less coinciding with my birth. And therefore, it manifests the idea of modernism and modern architecture at its best. You are very lucky, you're blessed, in fact, to be educated in such an extraordinary space where nature has given full rein and you are not dominated by the urban environment. This whole campus is a dream of a better future. And I'm so glad that all these new graduates have inhabited it and have benefited from it. I have many things to say, and I can't really say them in a very short time. We've got to stop meeting like this, really. I'm looking at all your faces. I'm looking at, in fact, a manifestation of the human condition. And I wish the parliamentarians in Westminster could experience what I've just experienced. This, I must congratulate the university, because this is my seventh experience of a graduation ceremony. But this one, unlike the others, aspires to the condition of a total artwork. It's grand opera. And as you can see, the great attention has been paid to the costumes and to the setting. Now, I would like you to know that when a university becomes associated in my mind with a work of art, I think all is well with that university. This is the university of the future. Because being the age that I am, and have no time yet for the experience of a nursing home, I have to have some kind of proof that all is well with the world. I have to have an alternative to the experience, the saddening experience that we all have of the BBC 10 o'clock news or Channel 4 news, which is usually not about the lives of these marvelous young people. Well, not all of them that young, I'm happy to say, because education is a process which is a lifelong experience. And I now know that at the age of 86, that I really know very little about the human spirit. But I've been fortunate in that I've experienced every year since 1947 the blessing of the language of all the arts. Can you imagine that? 3 weeks, every year, what's that, 69 times 3 weeks, that's nearly 4 years of my life, blessed by the highest levels of international art, the one language that the world needs now. This is the language of the angels. It's the language which is our birthright. Joseph Beuys, arguably the greatest teacher of art of modern times, said, Famously, controversially, everyone is an artist. And by that he meant, trust the doctors, the nurses, the policemen, or maybe even the politicians, that you can regard as creative, as artists. But be very careful, if you cannot see evidence of their use of art language in their professional lives. I happen to know that there is a future for us all as long as we can depend on these young people. And I'd like to congratulate them as they advance towards the great challenge of the 21st century. Oh my God, it's the 21st century already. But we're still possessed of too many people thinking it's the 20th century. And using 20th century ideas, which are useless. I know the 20th century very well because I lived through it. The war, that ridiculous, pathetic, tragic event, which produced some of the most extraordinary manifestations of madness that the world's ever seen. And then the Cold War, which separated half of Europe from where we are now. I want you to know that I am so pleased to be here, but full of frustration that I can't meet all of you. I'd like to congratulate all the parents, the grandparents, the families of these people who have just graduated. You should be very pleased that they've decided to use the language of the arts, because this is the language we're going to have to depend on to deal with, for example, the challenge, the problem of Brexit. Oh, I've used the word. I didn't want to use it. It's an ugly word. It's a kind of swear word. Because I can say, can I just say clearly to you that the world of academe, seeing these extraordinarily garbed human beings, look at them, how extraordinarily dignified they are, how beautiful they are. They are the personification of what we'd all wish the 21st century to be. They're committed to the concept of knowledge and wisdom, not information. That's a bad thing. Information can't actually produce the one thing that identifies a situation as artistic. I think it was Einstein who said, all the information in the world doesn't add up to anything compared to the world of imagination. And imagination is the sound of music, the great poetry, the great theater, the great painting, the great sculpture, the great language, which is the language, dare I say it to you all, because I think you know it in your hearts. It's not the language of art that I'm talking about. It's the language of love. We've got to use it because we're born to love. I dare say that now I've fallen in love with all of you. And I'm very conscious of my frailty as a human being. How can I express that love? I can express that love by committing myself as I have done in the whatever it is that I have ahead of me. I don't have a 5-year plan, by the way. But using every day with the language that they have learned here, they can teach us how to love. And the reason we've got Brexit
is that the argument for and against was not about love. It was about confusion, misinformation, stupidity, greed, power. Your job is to use that wonderful language which Keats defined. Very simply, he said, all you need to know in this world as a human being is that truth is beauty, and beauty is truth. My goodness me, that's all you need to know, yes. Because when a thing is beautiful and true, it's a great thing for the human race. And we need it desperately. We need it now. Maybe we should invite Theresa May to be here. The big flaw in her life is that she's probably never been to this campus. And it was created by a Scotsman, more or less. He helped Andrew Carnegie. And I just want to say one last thing here. I guess this must be the only graduation ceremony that's unified the world of politics. Think of the poor devils who have got to use that language. Nothing to do with art. It's a language of division, of hopelessness, confusion. I think the language of art is the way forward. And I would like to say I'm grateful to the 26 parliamentarians, 26, who supported a motion in Parliament about a week ago. And the motion was, we congratulate the University of Leeds Beckett, and therefore all of you who are gathered here, to take the risk, I suppose, of giving an honorary doctorate to someone who has benefited from the miracle of the Edinburgh Festival. Let us hope that I can think of you and the Edinburgh Festival as one space in the future. I need you to help. If there's going to be a future for the Edinburgh Festival, it has to be with your extraordinary use of art. So think, for the first time in history, Parliament, oh, by the way, not Westminster, Hollywood, want to take the world of the university seriously, and very seriously indeed, when it's about the proper use, the loving use of the language of all the arts. I thank you for this great honor. I thank you, all of you. I'm proud to be among you. I'll never forget this day. It's been a long time coming, but I'm so glad I've lived long enough to see that I have every right to have faith in the future, your future, all of you here. Thank you.
I now invite Andrew Fryer, Head of School, to present graduands from the School of Film, Music and Performing Arts.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I am pleased to present graduands for the following awards. For the award of Bachelor of Arts Music Production, I present Luke Gagan. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Animation, I present Ingrio Kizjantoro. Michelle Lambert. Ashley Mools. Kaya Oldacre. Omotola Oyefodunrin. Megan Parkin. Robert Poller. Kurt Railton. Brogan Page Sidhu. Victoria Tomlin. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Dance, I present Joanna Bangan. Jake Brocklehurst. Leah Jade Bygrave. Miriam Clay. Gabrielle Cook. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Yorkshire Dance Catalyst Award, Jake Daniels. Emily Davies. Laura Debney. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Yorkshire Dance Catalyst Award to Stephanie Donohoe. Bethan Ellis. Emily Farr. Jessica Finney. Ebony Godridge. Rachel Harris. Zenaida Harris Gonzalez. Amy Hill. Laura Kay. Emma Lott. Sophie Massey. Rachel Nagy. Bethany Poynton. Victoria Pollitt. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Excellence in Dance to Maria Popova. Holly Rogers. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Yorkshire Dance Catalyst Award to Hannah Shipman. Constance Stockhill. Catherine Vanna. Victoria Walker. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Film and Moving Image Production, I present Harrison Ahrens. Joseph Newbury. Sadhana Tarja. Sophie Zaros. For the award of Bachelor of Arts Filmmaking, I present Joshua Andrews. Oliver Bagshaw. Isabel Bailey. Richard Bedford. Connor Bennett. Natasha Berry. Jordan Bickerstaff. Abigail Blackow. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Derek Woolbank Prize for most insightful use of illustrations in the dissertation to Sunny Bugard. Oliver Broadbent. Aidan Bryan. Spencer Burke. Lewis Burton. Sarah Carney. Rebecca Charlton. Thomas Conway. Joseph Cook. Ryan Denny. Olivia Dixon. George Earl. Samuel Evans. Nicholas Galicia. Matthew Gentleman. Gemma Gibson. Mark Godbell. Elvelyn Gredich. Zoe Harrison. James Hawkins. George Jenkins. James Johnson. Kieran Kinnaird. Zach Kovacs-Buttery. Sean Lewis. Tala Lockhart. Florin Magne. Stefan Mayle. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Excellence in Film to Natasha Mattox. Edward Morn. Stephen McBrearty. Nathaniel Miller. Amy Morris. Joanna Munley. Joshua Munro. Lindsay Miles. Rosa Nolan Warren. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the ProVision Prize for Most Enterprising Steward to Rebecca Norbury. And I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Andrew Hirshhorn Memorial Prize for Feature-Length Screenplay to Christopher Parkinson. Anu Pekarinen. Sarah Perry. Ashley Rickson. Benjamin Robinson. Cameron Riles. Ibrahim Saeed. Bethany Scott. William Sparks. Thomas Stibbs. Dominic Thompson. Ryan Tomlin. Michael Turnbull. Rebecca Turner. Vikas Vasudevan. Eleanor Waddy. Ruby Walker. Jamie Waller. Bethan Williams. Ryan Williams. Adam Ragg. Rafiq Fuad Yaramadi. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Music Production, I present Robert Barnett. Daniel Britton. Alexander Brown. Lloyd Brown. George Cooper. Kevin Cowley. Igor Dalavansi. John Davison. Matthew Dewar. David Doonan. Liam Duggan. Jonathan Ellis. Luca Fagagnini. Cameron Gavin. Adam Granger. Kelly Groman. Jonathan Hanlon McNabb. Carl Harrison. Matthew Hossein. Luke Hudson. Christopher Hughes. Joe Joyner. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the James Prize to William Killen. Andrew Curdley. Jonah Lambton. James Lee. Christopher Lightowler. David McClelland. Conrad Morley. Jack Muncaster. Jonathan Naylor. Lewis Nolan. Andrew North. Jessica Palmer. Zach Pigel. Jade Rhodes. Elliot Wrigley. James Robertson. Harry Scott. James Stubbs. James Thomas. David Thompson. Jasper Thorne. Hannah Thornycroft. Oliver James Thornton. Connor Tissington. Lewis Warman. Ann Wong. Jack Wood. Annabelle Young. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Music Production and Performance, I present Elliot Alexson. Michael Barley. Amanda Bell. Shirley Bramble Nash. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for the music student with the highest average final year grade to Robbie Carruthers. James Clayton. Jason Dixon. Peter Fielding. Jonathan Hewlett-Davies. James Moffat. Catherine O'Neill. Jasmine Shekilua. Amy Schickel. Courtney Smith. Phoenicia Williams. For the award of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Music Technology, I present James Abraham. Jonathan Ainsley. Robert Ankers-Mota. Benjamin Argyropoulos. Vicky Barber. Robbie Baxendale. Jack Cardwell. Jack Coates. Arthur Davies. Thomas Denegi Berry. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the AMS Neave Limited Prize to Ryan Dunsmuir. Thomas Dwelly. Alex Etal. Jack Florentine. Austin Foster. David Freak. Kyle Gaywood. Kieran Grief. Rory Hebblethwaite. Simon Howlett. Brody Jameson. Matthew Johnson. Adam Jones. Daniel Jones. Jordan Lord. Dima Lutza. Harry Matthews. Ethan McDade. Craig Mitchinson. Felix Morgan. Scott Nangle. Jonathan Parks. Aaron Peake. Luke Pearson. Adam Porter. Henry Reaver. Benjamin Robinson. Jake Schofield. Marcus Shreve. Alex Smith. Patrick Sneezum. Stephen Spark. Joshua Spencer. Harry Staley. Benjamin Swales. Benjamin Taylor. Joel Thompson. Matthew Turner. Jack Bourne. Stanley Vickery. Edward Whaley. Lee Whitehall. Daniel Wilkinson. Oliver Wood. Alexander Young. Robin Young. Rowan Young. Mark Zabrzycki. For the award of Bachelor of Arts with Honours Performance, I present Paris Brown. Joanna Ellis. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Liftoff and Transform Award for Excellence in Performance to Sasha Foister. Chelsea Hare. And I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Liftoff and Transform Award for Excellence in Performance to Grace Hargreaves. Emma Holmes. Leah Kitchener. Paula Lyons. Leah Kitchener. Paula Lyons. Courtney Jade Moriarty. Sophie Pickering. Kieran Reed. Daniel Riley. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Dean's Prize for Excellence in Performance to Jennifer Skinner. Danielle Tolhurst. For the award of Postgraduate Certificate Sound Design, I present Ashley Congreve. For the award of Master of Science, Audio Engineering, I present James Gilby. For the award of Master of Arts, Filmmaking, I present David Braunz. Lorenzo Garcia Polak. Amritha Subayan Krishnan. Carlos Vargas Matiz. Yin Wang. Naixin Zhang. For the award of Master of Arts Music for the Moving Image, I present Maria Chrysostomo. Tom Wallner. For the award of Master of Arts Music Production, I present Laura Etema. Richard Formby. John Kennedy. Daniel Lloyd Evans. Roland Palmer. Laura Tolson. For the award of Master of Arts Performance, I present Charlotte Blackburn. Martin Ferry. Liam Gordon. Laura Hillary. I'm also pleased to present the winner of the Noel Witts Award for Excellence to Faye McDool. Dawn Robinson. For the award of Master of Science, Sound and Music for Interactive Games, I present Jordan Hartley. Joseph Marsh. I now invite Professor Phil Cardew to present research awards for the School of Film, Music and Performing Arts. Thank you.
Doctor of Philosophy is awarded to candidates who have pursued a program of individual research leading to work of publishable quality. Each candidate would have written a substantial thesis and have been examined by a panel of experts in the viva voce examination. For the thesis titled, Between the Imaginary and the Concrete, Scenography for Contemporary Dance, Shizuku's research examined five design methods and design concepts that underpin her own scenographic process. The analysis demonstrated the parallels between architectural and scenographic design methodologies and the possibilities that exist in a cross-disciplinary spatial practice. The research will provide a valuable and instructive approach for further design for contemporary dance. I present Dr. Shizuka Halu. Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, the names of the students graduating in absentia are recorded in the programme. That concludes the presentation of awards for the School of Film, Music and Performing Arts.
I now welcome Professor Andrew Slade, Deputy Vice-Chancellor of our university, to address us.
Well, follow that, but I'll try. Distinguished guests, graduands, staff, parents, family, and friends. My very first task is to ask all of our graduands to please stand. By virtue of the authority vested in me, I now formally confer upon you the awards and degrees of Leeds Beckett University for which you have recently qualified. Congratulations. Please be seated. Graduates, doesn't that sound good? We are all here today to celebrate your achievements. It is a real privilege and a pleasure for us to be able to share in your success. Of course, you didn't make it here alone. You have been supported by family, friends, fellow students, bank managers, bartenders, and of course, and not least, our own university staff. Thank you to everyone who has helped you on your journey. But as I look at you now, I wonder, how are you feeling? Mixed emotions, I guess. On the one hand, a mixture of pride at completing your degree, and the warmth you feel about being here as part of a community of fellow students with whom you have navigated the ups and downs of some of the best years of your life. On the other, perhaps a vague sense of unease about what comes next. Tomorrow, as they say, is the first day of the rest of our lives, and who knows what the future may hold. Well, let me try to help. Firstly, everything's going to be okay. Now, how do I know this? Well, I'll tell you one reason why. I've read very carefully evidence presented to a government review of higher education, evidence based on the career trajectories of almost 12 million graduates in Britain. The author, Lord Brown, concluded in his report, and I quote, "Higher education transforms the lives of individuals. Graduates are more likely to be employed, more likely to enjoy higher wages with better job satisfaction, and more likely to find it easier to move from one job to another. Graduates enjoy substantial health benefits, are less likely to be involved in crime, more likely to be actively involved with their children's education, and more likely to be active in their communities." Well, so how does that work? How does higher education particularly create this very positive transformation of what sociologists call life chances? Well, for me, it's a combination of three very important factors. First, the important knowledge and skills you have worked so hard to acquire. What you have learned, I can assure you, will have utility and will prove useful. But it's a very sobering thought to reflect that knowledge has its own lifespan. Most of what we know today will become redundant at some point in the future. And due to the speed at which knowledge is growing and being disseminated, that point always comes sooner than you think. So that brings me to the second factor. In acquiring all that knowledge and all those skills, you have learned how to learn. And you will have done this in a way that is uniquely your own. By continuing to be a reflective practitioner, the application of your method of learning to everything you do in the future will help you to manage and adapt to change more effectively. And finally, the third, and perhaps the most important factor, is the set of values your program of study has helped you to develop. It is no longer fashionable in our postmodern society to speak of shared values, but our whole university system is built on them. During your studies, you will have been led day after day, week after week, semester after semester, to make a series of judgments about what you are being taught, what you have read, and what you have learned. Those judgments will rest on verifiable evidence. In considering that evidence, you will have been encouraged to be objective, to listen carefully to people whose views and opinions differ from your own, and to consider extremely carefully what they have to say. You will have had to have learned to form your own opinions and then be prepared to stand up for them by weighing the evidence, the claim, the counterclaim, and to explain and back up your own approach, your own point of view. In that process, which you have now made your own, you have been encouraged to be objective, to be fair, and to be tolerant. In doing so, you have subscribed not only to the code of conduct of our university, but to codes of conduct which underpin the basis of any democratic and civilized society. So your degree today represents a triumph of commitment and perseverance in the gaining of important knowledge, skills, and values. And it is those things, the commitment, the perseverance, the knowledge, the skills, and the values, which taken together will, day after day, set you apart in living a good and successful life. I would like to thank you all for the richness you have brought to our university during your time with us. A university is nothing without its students and its staff. So thank you for making our university the place it is today. You will all have dreams you want to follow, aspirations you aim to achieve. We all wish you the best of luck with those future goals. I sincerely hope you've enjoyed your time with us, that it has opened your mind and expanded your thinking, that it has and will continue to open doors, and it has encouraged you to challenge the norm, and that it has been an experience you will treasure for the rest of your life. On behalf of everyone here at Leeds Beckett University, please enjoy the rest of the day. Enjoy your celebrations with your friends and family, and please accept our very best wishes for the future. Thank you.
Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, graduates and guests. Before we close, please join me in congratulating again all those who have just graduated, and also in thanking everyone who's contributed to our ceremony today, and of course, the Black Dyke Band. Chair of the Board of Governors, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, graduates and guests, I now declare the formal proceedings closed. Please all now rise for the academic procession and remain standing until the procession has left the hall.